everybody. Welcome to the Dad Chunch Podcast. My name's Dad. How are you doing today? It is a glorious day because there is beef. And we love beef. Beef between family vloggers. It's the showdown of the century. Matt and Abby, or I like to call Twat and Scabby, versus this girl named Leanna or something. And like baby names and things. I'm definitely going to inject myself into this conversation and it's going to be funny. Let's talk about it. So if you're new to the Matt and Abby thing, so am I. I've discovered Matt and Abby through this other beast and bumholes or whatever they're called. They did an interview with them and they all cried about being called exploiters. It's just silly. Every time I kind of start snarking on a family or family vlog like this, I go to their snark thread. When this one is Matt and Abby Snarks on Reddit, they've got only 1.7 thousand members. So let's get them numbers up there. Those are rookie numbers. So let's make sure that these people are talked about a little bit more, shall we? Okay, so you sort by new. And they are just like, it's like all the other snark threads. But there are some things that did pop up, including this article. So, and it's on the New York Post, which is kind of crazy. Not gonna lie to you. New York Post is covering shit like this. But the beef starts when Matt and Abby, I guess, call out naming your kid weird names. Which, you know, I don't like Twat and Scabby, but they're right. Guys, you need to be careful what you name your children. Because if you name your kids weird shit, and I know this is like, oh, you shouldn't be talking about kids' names. It's not against the children. This is against the parents who are doing it. I feel like it's for you, right? You guys know those people, right? Name their kids weird spellings of normal names, or they name their kids weird shit like Tana Licciardo, or kids are named weird stuff. Well, you have to realize when you name your child is their futures. Now, if you're Kardashians and Ye, and you name your kid Northwest, okay, that's a little bit different. Your kid's gonna grow up to be a billionaire, so it really doesn't matter, not really. But if you're just a normal ass person naming your kid weird shit, please take into consideration your child's future. Can we be there though, at least a little bit? So let's look at this article. Influencer breaks down over backlash to baby's different name. An influencer is broken down in tears. Oh, not an influencer tears. Oh my God. Cue sad music. My God, influencer tears. These poor people who make millions of dollars online showing their lives. They are crying. Ugh. Finn, shut your pie holes. She's in tears for her baby's unusual name, copped backlash for being ridiculous and off the wall, which, okay. British couple Leanna Jade and Connor Darlington named their 8-month-old baby Koazi. Pronounced, oh, cozy. Well, that is a dumb name. Sorry, I agree. Don't name your kid Cozy. And a lot of people are going to be mad at me for saying that, but I don't care. Because I say the thing that most people are thinking. Don't name your kid Cozy. What is even the nickname for Cozy? Z? Coz? Koa? Koa, maybe, because it's spelt with a K-O-A. He didn't even spell it Cozy. So let's just think of this kid's future for the rest of his life, okay? When you get to school, is Koazi here? It's Cozy. Okay, well, your parents spelled it wrong. For the rest of their life, they're going to be spelling it. What's your name? Cozy. Okay. No, it's K-O-A-Z-Y. Oh, yeah. My parents spelled it wrong. The whole time. My parents are narcissists, and so they named me Cozy because they didn't care about my future. Now, it's not that big of a deal in the end if you got a weird name, okay? But it's just, why are you going to add shit to that? So I kind of agree with Matt and Abby if they did say that it was stupid, that it's stupid. Okay? I'm there with you. However, the popular YouTubers who have 2.71 million followers have had their unorthodox choice of a moniker on a new podcast prompting 24-year-old Leanna to clap back. Did she clap back? Okay, well. With those nails, clap back when you try to wipe your ass. It's gonna hurt. The mom of one was visibly upset as she explained new and unique baby names had been a subject of the unplanned podcast hosted by couples Twat and Scabby Howard. While Matt and Abby didn't mention Koazi by name, I'm going to say it, they branded unusual monikers ridiculous and out of control, which I agree with, even though their kid's name is Griffin, which isn't out of the blue. It's not the craziest thing. But you know what I'm trying to say is that those people who name their kids, and you know it with me, we can all agree that there are weird names for children, right? We can all agree, right? Right? Let's take, for example, someone like this douchebag, Nick Cannon. Now, if you don't know anything about Nick Cannon, he was an actor who played in Drumline, which is a pretty decent movie when I was growing up, but decided he's going to spread his seed all over and create fatherless homes galore, which I think is silly. So Nick Cannon is going around spreading his seed to anybody who will take him, okay? And he is creating tons of fatherless homes. But this is his kids' names. Moroccan Scott Cannon, Monroe. Those are kind of normal. Powerful Queen, Beautiful Zeppelin, Legendary Love, Onyx Ice Coal, Rise Messiah, Golden Cannon, Zillionaire, and Zion Mixolydian. Okay? And because I say the things you guys sometimes are often too scared to say, that's silly. That's dumb, and that's selfish. Parents who do this are selfish. Prove me wrong. So anyway, the mama one, she's upset Matt and Abby didn't mention Kwazi. Abby added it was a red flag to give a child a name that doesn't already exist, saying it might not be the flex you think it is. Abby said that? I mean, how dare, like, I know that Matt and Abby are kind of right on the subject, but how dare people who exploit children online ever have anything to say about other people's parenting? You can kiss the inside of my anus cavity. So there's Lina Jade. There's Lyanna Jade and all of her, oh my gosh, and all of her camel glory. So Lyanna Jade also, guys, and we're going to look at this in a second, is a family vlogger who exploits her children. This is a picture of Lyanna Jade literally with her camel toe and her baby. Okay? If I can tell your religion in your pants and you're holding your child, maybe just rethink the photo. The pair, who expecting their second child, left comment section of their video open. Oh my gosh, did they? Which enabled others to blast Lyanna and Connor's choice. The saga has left Lyanna distraught. So I don't understand. Why is Lyanna pissed? They didn't mention Kwazi by name. So why were people saying Kwazi? They just said, oh, this person, Kwazi? Okay, whatever. With the young mom explaining why Kwazi's name isn't everyone's cup of tea, she thinks it's cruel to allow people who don't like her baby's name to rip at it. Well, let me tell you something, Lyanna. I don't know if you knew this or not, but you could just not share your child with the internet. She has 8 million fans on TikTok. You ever given that thought? You're so upset that people are going to call your baby out? You put your baby on the internet. Now, I know it's not, you shouldn't make fun of children. You shouldn't, okay? But it's not their fault they have weird names. That's the parents' fault. Also, the parents are off, the kids should be off limits, but they're not. That's the thing, everybody. You put your child on the internet. You're opening your, especially up to 8 million and 2 million on YouTube. What are you thinking? You think you're not going to get some pushback? You think there's not going to be a bunch of crazy creepers inside of that 10 million fan base that are going to be weird and creepy or have problems with you? Are you out of your mind? The saga has left Lyanna distraught. Oh no. With the young mom explaining why Kwazi's name isn't everyone's cup of tea. She thinks like blah, blah, blah. People have said we call him Cozy because he was cozy in the womb. But no, it was a name we already had and I was getting so heavily pregnant. People were saying he's so cozy in your belly. She explained in a tearful video. Okay, we're going to watch that video. It confirmed to us that's what we should name him. And we were like, oh my God, it's meant to be. I promise you don't thank God for that. Okay. Again, think of your child's future. But they don't. None of them do. They don't care. Obviously, or they wouldn't exploit their children, right? Lyanna wanted to say, I wasn't trying to name him anything for a flex, adding the opening comment section allowed others to mock their baby name. It really upset her. Well, I'm sorry it really upset you, but you did this to you. Matt and Abby are dingleberries, and so are you. I knew everyone wasn't going to love the name, so I'm not going to sit here defending it. Everyone is entitled to their own opinion. That's where this should all end. That's why you shouldn't make videos crying on the internet. Why are you making tearful influencer crying videos and then saying this? Everyone is entitled to their own opinion. Okay, then shut your pie hole. They get the opinion because you put the shit out there. People are going to be opinionated about your content because you put it there. But it's just different when there's this comment section open on such a big influencer's video of people. Fully grown adults just sat there slandering my baby's name. So again, this is what Abby said. I'm not like, you know, I'm like, you know, your child is going to grow up and be an adult. I'm like, that might not be the flex you think it is. Now, I don't know this, which podcast they're talking about, if they were talking about her. But it looks like they found out that's who they were talking about. I think it's quite cruel. And if I'd posted that video personally, I think it would have been very mindful of who was being named and how it can have effect on other people. Fans of Lyanna have been quick to chime in, telling the mom it was a sweet name and urging her not to listen to critics. Don't listen to the haters, slay queen. When in the reality, look, naming your kid weird stuff is just because you're selfish. And it tends to happen on channels where they're putting their entire lives on the internet. Right? It just so happens to be those influencers name their kids attention-seeking names. It's odd, right? That it just kind of lands there. It's just weird. It's a weird coincidence. Don't cry, hun. It's an amazing name. They just don't have good taste, one commented. Cozy's a lovely name. As one urged, Cozy's a lovely nickname, not a real name for a person. What if Cozy wants to be a politician? Cozy wants to, you know, work in banking or something. Just Cozy, anything, okay? But these parents want to set their kids up to be influencers. And so that's a cool name for an influencer because they think that that's all that their only worth is going to come from that because that's where the parents' worth comes from. As one urged, please don't, Please don't upset. Everyone has an opinion. Matt and Abby have since turned off the comments in their video, but it has been widely recirculated. In it, the pair declare baby names have gotten out of control in 2023. It does bug me some of the names that are out there nowadays. They're just so off the wall, Abby states. And Abby, you're dumb. Because you exploit your child for money. Dumbass. You know your child's going to grow up and be an adult and potentially work in a professional setting. Matt declares he completely agrees with his partner. Does he? Describing cute names for kids that don't translate well into adult names is scary. Some people are so proud they don't know anyone's name. Some people are so proud they don't know anyone named by this name that they might not be the flex you think it is, Abby adds. That might be a red flag. So people are looking for names that nobody else has. And it, unfortunately, it happened, and they're right, that those names that nobody has, the reason nobody has those names is because they're dumb. So let's look at this Leanna crybaby video, and I'll show you what she's going on about. Let's see if she has a right to be upset. No, sorry. So before I play this video, let's set the scene. Imagine 2023, banks are failing. Eggs are $9,000. It costs $1 million to feed your family and drive anywhere with gas prices the way they are. There are so many problems in the world that are so important. There's a war going on with the potential to open up to World War III, okay? So many people are hurting in this economy that we're in worldwide, okay? There's so much going on. And this is your problem that you're going to cry on the internet about. So we're setting that scene for you just so we can set it up properly. So this is Leanna with her shitty nails.
Oh, man. I don't know if I'm
going to... I'm going to post this video, but I'm going to post it. I didn't want to make this video, but I made the video.
I don't know if I'm going to post this video. And it is absolutely... No hate, but...
No hate.
You might have seen that the couple, Matt and Abby, I know this is just their opinion, but they posted...
Just pull yourself together first, okay? Be an adult. Again, imagine this was what your problems are. Somebody made fun of my kid's name that I named them weird. You should expect... I mean, you know you expected this, right? You know that there was going to be pushback for your naming kid Cozy, right? You knew this. You probably had a conversation with your shitty husband that you're going to be doing this, and they're going to... What if they get pushback? Did you not have a conversation of, hey, what do you think's going to happen with our kid when they get older? Did you not have that conversation at all? Clearly, they don't care because they exploit their child. We're going to find out here in a second.
A clip on the TikTok and the YouTube shorts that they pulled out of their podcast, and they were talking about sort of like people naming their kids like new original names.
No, dumb names. They didn't say new and original. You said
they
that.
Clipped what they were speaking about on their podcast, and they were saying how ridiculous some of these like new unique names were.
Mm-hmm.
Basically,
they are.
Our baby is called Cozy, and I know it's not everybody's cup of tea, right?
It's nobody's cup of tea, including your child who has to live with the name, guys. You parents realize that they're going to be an autonomous adult someday, right? With their own identity. You know that, right? People change their name all the time, and I get that. But you know that they're going to go... What these parents name their kid this way because they like the tension they get from it, negative or positive. So I'm sorry, I don't like you.
I know that it's not everybody's cup of tea.
Just say cup of tea.
Kind of like pulled it out of context, said that we've called him Cozy because he was Cozy.
Oh, it's a boy's name.
Mm-hmm. Well, no, it was a name that we already had.
So?
And...
doesn't make it any less dumb. What kind of excuse is this? Well, it's a name we had already. It was dumb then too. Right? It was weird then. It's weird now. Just because you had it beforehand doesn't make it better. What is the logic? These people who grew up on the internet, who use the internet for their whole lives, clearly these people didn't go to school. I don't even know them. I don't know any of their content. Probably got married as teenagers or whatever. Probably didn't finish school. Did not go to college, that's for sure. Okay? Clearly have nothing to offer the world like all these other family vloggers. What did they bring the world? What did they bring you?
As I was getting so heavily pregnant... People were saying that he was Cozy in your belly, you know, he was, and it kind of like confirmed to us, I think that's what we should name him.
Mm-hmm. So you named him a weird spelling too, that's okay. Mm-hmm.
Because we already had that name and people were saying it and it was
one person probably made a comment, okay.
It was meant to be kind of thing.
Let me get this right. Because you had the name Quasi for your child, who's a boy. Then someone said, the baby looks cozy in your belly. You took that as a sign to name your kid Cozy. that a stranger on the internet said your baby was Cozy, and so you named your kid Cozy. Do you guys not see how potentially that could be? What? Seriously? You don't see the problem with that? Okay. Call me crazy.
And to name him anything for a flex. It's open.
Yes, you did. You did. Yes, you did. Yes. And these parents who, again, if you are chronically online, your entire lives are online. If I can see your entire body and everything else that goes in it, online and out of it, online, and you post daily content of your entire lives and you make money off this thing, why is it such a far-fetched to believe you did something as a flex to get the attention that you wanted from it? Because everything you do is for attention, because the attention you get pays you. So sorry, your logic is off.
The comment section. To allow all of these people who didn't like our baby name to just rip at it.
Oh no.
Really upset. I knew everyone wasn't gonna love the name.
Stop, you're crying like a 4-year-old. You're an adult, right? You're a parent? All you had to do is come and say, hey guys, you don't like my baby's name? Kiss my ass. Peace. And then everybody, yes, queen, you into the oblivion with all the likes and hearts you're going to get. Instead, you want to cry on the internet for naming your kid something weird, which you knew was weird because you even state that you know it's not going to be everyone's cup of tea and people are going to have a problem with it. Okay? But the reason why it's a problem is because you put it on the internet and you put your child on the internet. This is a choice that you make daily, actively, in real time. And you don't like the pushback you get? Well, that's sorry. That's what you're bringing your child into as well. And you know what? You know what's so funny about all this and the irony of all this is that they're bringing their child into this world where she's crying about getting called on the internet and have no problem with bringing their child into that world. Talk about having no self-awareness.
And so I'm not going to sit here defending it. Well, everyone is entitled
because it's indefensible
to their own opinion, but it's just different.
See?
When there's this comment section open on such a big influencer's video of people just fully grown adults just sat there slandering my baby's name.
And if this doesn't give you pause for a second to say, oh my God, am I bringing my child into a world where fully grown adults are going to be slandering my child's name, right? It doesn't give you pause, except you're just going to be the victim here. You're going to sit there and you're not going to have any self-awareness to say, am I really going to bring my kid into that world where these people exist? Because there's nothing I can do about it. They will always exist, but you're going to continue to do it, aren't you? You're not going to have an aha moment here, a little light bulb that goes off and says, you know what? I'm going to take my kid off this platform because if it's toxic for me, it's also toxic for them. And let's be real, everybody. They're not making fun of your child. Your child's probably beautiful. Your child, a baby is a baby. They're innocent. These kids are innocent in this, everybody. Where the people are making fun of you and your choices, not the baby, not the kid. The kid is innocent in all this. You, for the flex and the attention you're going to get from naming your son something weird, is exactly what you were looking for. And when you get the thing you're looking for, you make this snotty cry video. Make it make sense.
I think it's quite cruel. And if I'd have posted that video personally,
I think some people would consider you naming your kid Cozy cruel.
And I was going to express that opinion that I had. I think I'd be very mindful of who was being named and how that could have an effect on other people.
She just cuts it off. And you know what? I don't feel sorry for her at all. And I know I don't like Matt and Abby just as much as I don't like any of these people who do any of this shit, okay? But here they are. Here's the Clam Fam. I call them Clam Fam. They're CL Fam. It's always the freaking first. They're so dumb. F off, get something original. So this is Clam Fam, and About Channel shows them that they are, thank you so much for subscribing. You guys mean the world to us. You're just part of the family now. That's nice. Strangers are part of your family? And they have 1.1 billion views. They've made a million plus. They've made eight figures, millions and millions of dollars off YouTube alone, and they have 8 million on TikTok as well. They probably have a massive Instagram, but this is what they do. If you sort their videos by popular, what shows up? Our realistic birth experience. She's sitting there calling out Matt and Abby, who is doing the exact same bullshit that she's doing. All these people, it's like the Spider-Man meme. They all do the same thing. Look at the top videos. Our realistic birth, it's always the birthing video that gets the most on these channels, by the way. 7 months ago, same with Matt and Abby. They have a little bit more than them. Meet our baby, 3.6 million. If you say babe, you have to remove a layer of clothing challenge. That's nice that you're going to have that on the internet for your kids to watch later. That's got 3.4 million views. Okay? So getting naked on YouTube channel for views and likes. And she's going to cry. That's nice. Telling my boyfriend I'm pregnant. Big bucks. Gender reveal. Big bucks. And then there's like this 8 months ago, we had to make a big decision. I don't know what it is. Probably something to do with the baby. Catfishing my boyfriend to see if he cheats. That's nice. Don't ever do that to your spouse. Okay, people? That's disgusting if you do that. Our new life with newborn. Again, all the same bullshit. So, Clam Fam, forgive me if I don't, like, side with you like these other newspapers. And the thing is, the newspaper isn't siding with them. They're just calling out how stupid all these people really are. And they're just looking for... It looks like an AI wrote this article anyway. So, Matt and Abby come out and do their shit. And they're obviously talked about a lot for doing this. And they came out and apologized. And they're like, we're real sorry that you left our comments open. And this is what she wrote. She's like... And because she was looking for the attention. So hear me out. This is the thing that's so funny about these people, that these influencers who crave so much attention. And you know they crave attention because they name their child Cozy. Thank you for everyone's kind words about my latest TikTok. Yes, queen. Well, we all know that I'm not one for speaking about anything, really, because I absolutely hate confrontation. But I couldn't let that one slide. It really upset me. It has all been resolved now, and I'm not going to allow it to ruin another day. Also, I don't think why some people understand why I got so upset. When you become a mummy, the feelings you get towards your baby are indescribable. So then seeing a comment section inviting hundreds of people to say such things is heartbreaking. If it was about me, I don't think I'd have cared. But because it was about him and my parenting, I couldn't deal. So you just said it was about your parenting. And it is not about your child. This is all about you, Leanne. And the fact that you don't see that is actually crazy. That you think this is about your people making fun of your... They're not making fun of your baby. They're making fun of the name that you gave your baby. The silly name you gave your baby boy. Cozy. His name is Cozy. So, don't be dumb. Please stop being dumb, people. Thank you. Here's the official apology from Twat and Scabby. So sorry to hear that you received hate from the comment section of our video. We have turned off the comments. That's nice. A video... At video, as that's the last thing we want... Oh, on that video, as that's the last thing we want. Your baby is cute and we wish nothing but the best for you guys. What have we learned in this little drama saga? All of these people are idiots. They're all bad. They're all attention seeking. They all want confrontation. They thrive in drama. If someone can make fun of your baby's name, just ignore it. You chose this for your child. And it's so funny, and again, I'll say this, and so ironic, that you do not see a problem with bringing your child into this world that you are gonna have snotty cry sessions on TikTok over. This world that can be so hateful to everybody on the internet, especially anybody, doesn't matter what you do, family vlogger or not, just regular people get hate, especially on Reddit and stuff like that, just regos, okay? If you can't see that that's a dangerous place because you think it's dangerous for you, that you're putting your kid in that same position, you don't see that that's wrong, then I have nothing for you. You're dumb. But all you do is prove that this place is always unsafe for children, no matter what. And you continue to put them on the internet. Twat and Scabby are just as bad. And they're absolutely capitalizing on this pregnancy. They're like, this is unplanned. They started a podcast called Unplanned because they had an unplanned pregnancy 5 months after they had their other baby. Does that sound unplanned to you? It's planned. These people are stupid. Now, I've learned a bunch since covering them that they have said on their videos a bunch of times that she thought that breastfeeding was a good way, was a good form of birth control. These people influence people. People? Hear me out? They thought that they couldn't get pregnant because she was breastfeeding. These people don't even know how this works, and they're exploiting children on the internet without even knowing how this works. They planned this because having babies on the internet is fully one of the most lucrative things you can do. They're being called out specifically because they're a-holes. And they should be, because they're a-holes. Okay, so we can't let this video go without snarking on a Matt and Abby video. Their most recent one that's gone a little bit more viral, one over 1 million views about how she had to set up a camera to look at the pregnancy test she already knew was positive. So Twat and Scabby, this one's for you. It's time to roast. Look at that Matt and Abby went on their podcast with... the beast in bumholes, and said, you know, we really need protection for kids. We need to be careful with this. They all are considering not putting their kids on the internet and yet continue every single day to ignore that shit that they said. Like everybody else that I cover, they don't even realize the things that they have said in past videos and the shit that we can see compared to what they're saying now. That's how chronically online they are. They don't even know what stance they've taken in the past. So let's watch this bullshit.
Holy crap. It's gonna be all right, honey.
It's just getting darker.
It's gonna be okay.
Shave your nipples, bro.
Yes, of course.
Do you know how much money we're going to make on this video and this series of videos and me unplugging your belly and pretending you're sucking it in? You know how much money we're going to make on these viral videos? Of course I'm happy. This is millions of dollars in our bank account. What kind of question is that, silly goose? You silly damn goose. Yeah, I'm happy. We're going to be, your vag is going to be on the internet again. Your boobs are going to get way bigger when you're pregnant, so we can use that in thumbnails. Are you kidding me? Damn, woman, how dumb are you?
We need one more than one baby, it's okay.
Okay, but 5 months old.
I know. I know, that's definitely not, that wasn't the plan.
Okay, Matt, I'm ready. Okay, stand right here. And then I'm gonna...
Like, Matt doesn't know, she's about to announce that they're pregnant. What's this bag that I bought, that I went out and got myself? Matt, do you ever wear a shirt, bro? Just put a shirt on. Please, thanks. Appreciate it. We get it. We get it that you're a normal looking dude and you want to show off your pecs and stuff. We get it. You're proud of your body. That's real cool. Put a shirt on, dude. I pissed on the stick and now we're going to make millions.
Are you serious?
Oh my God. Apparently people want me to snark on their birth video, and I'm going to.
Oh my gosh!
What was the book?
Oh my goodness!
What to expect when not wearing a shirt? Wear a shirt.
Are you serious?
Present day. Let me set this camera.
I remember exactly how I felt in that moment and how nauseous I was and overwhelmed I was.
Emotions. Slay queen. So they're not even good actors, people. They're not even good actors. That's the thing that pisses me off, that people believe them. Like you, the thing that makes me the most upset about this type of content is that you think we're stupid. And the problem is that the people who watch them are stupid, so. Matt, can you come in here without your shirt on, please? Matt, take your shirt off.
I literally look like I'm acting.
So, and he comes up with a towel, so he was sleeping naked.
Right there.
Dude, look at me, I'm like still asleep right there.
Did she say she wasn't acting?
I literally look like I'm acting right there.
Cause you are acting right there, Scabby. You're acting.
Dude, look at me, I'm like still asleep right there.
Oh. Is this good for the thumbnail? Oh.
Here we go. Holy cow. 7:14 in the morning. Did you almost not record that?
I was totally not going and record because that's how sure I was that it was going to be negative.
You're such a damn liar. I wasn't going to record because I knew it's going to be negative. But then I recorded because I knew it was going to be negative. Just why you guys just tell the truth? Because they don't want you guys to see the truth. That's the problem here. They don't want you to see the truth. They're such fake liars.
Wait,
I thought that you couldn't get pregnant after having sex. What happened? What's going on?
I guess if there's even a chance, then I should record it because this could be a big moment. And turns out it was a huge...
And we can monetize it.
Huge moment.
And they monetized it for I mean, we're talking 90, I don't know, millions and millions and millions of views.
I started recording because I was like, there's no, I'm going to delete this immediately after.
Liar. You're such a liar.
What's your initial thought right there? Like, was it just fear? What?
Oh my God. This, we're going to get paid so much money for... We're going to start a podcast called Unplanned. This is so unplanned that we planned it.
Was it just shock?
I think I thought I was going to throw up. And so then I literally go immediately to get you.
That's so funny. I was so, so tired. It was hard to even get out of bed at that.
7:30 in the morning. Okay.
Point. I could tell that...
Your parents.
Like, you were kind of fearful and I got to get out of bed, whatever this is.
I think you can literally see my nippies and...
Ugh. Why would you point it out then?
Milk stains, because I was...
Oh my gosh.
Very much in our breastfeeding journey.
Dude, look at me. I'm like still asleep right there. I'm like...
Guy literally had a morning boner. He came up with a morning boner on. That's why he put a towel on.
Oh my gosh.
You're here.
I was in my underwear. I had to put on a towel because I was like, I guess I'm being recorded. I don't know what this is.
Oh, you don't know? Guys, do you believe anything coming out of their face holes? Anything? Okay, we already went through this.
So unreal that I was like, is there a chance that she's pranking me?
I was like, pregnancy pranks are off limits.
Never. I'm trying to think of like what I need to do to comfort you. Even though I was being affected by it, I knew it was going to affect.
You're being infected by it? Sounds like she was infected by it. You know what I'm saying? Sex.
affect you a lot more than it was affecting me.
Well, at least a lot sooner. My whole family is in this house too. Dude. We're on family vacation.
We're literally at Disney World. We're struggling to like enjoy our time with one kid and now.
Did you just say that, Matt? Did you just say we're struggling to enjoy our time with one kid? We're struggling to enjoy our time because we have a child. Damn, Matt. You get a song for that, bro.
Matt is a twat. What a twat you are, Matt. Did you just say that because you are dumb? You are dumb. Put a shirt on. Dumb. Twat. Matt's a twat. Such a twat. You moron. Nobody likes you.
Not my best song, but Matt, did you just say that shit, you idiot? And let's not look past the fact that these people are influencers and they're at Disneyland just for their regular life and they're struggling to enjoy it. Oh my God!
It's like, hey, you're gonna have two.
Hey, it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Why are you crying? Your kid's gonna see this, that you're like sad that you're pregnant. Okay? We love babies. They make us money. Look how much money we're gonna make, right? Damn.
I love that. You're so sweet.
I can't express
him. Hey. How do you not? How are you like? Yeah, completely. Don't wear protection. Nothing. Let's do this. How do you mean you're expecting this so soon? You're so stupid.
Okay.
Aw, honey.
Maybe you guys should do a video that says, hey, people who influence, just so you know, when you're breastfeeding, you can get pregnant. So don't listen to anything we say because we're stupid. That's the video you should do next. Let's hope that goes viral. Stop saying the same shit over again. And I'm starting to realize Scabby cries way too much. You cry too much, girl. Put your shit in check, okay? We get, you know, that stuff, stop crying. Relax.
My logical brain was like, okay, before we even like go further, can you just take another test?
I know it can happen with false positives, but I just know that that's very, very rare.
Yeah. My goodness. Oh.
Hey, Stinky. So now I'm sobbing.
Very
cute,
though, you know.
We know that we want to have more than one baby.
There's never.
Matt knows rings. Too many rings, bro.
There isn't.
Oh, it feels like that.
It's okay.
Oh my God, sex leads to pregnancy? Why didn't nobody tell me? People have failed you. These people Mormon? Because that would make sense then. Maybe Mormons don't want to tell the girls and educate the women about pregnancy because because having babies is a flex in Mormon culture. Like they just want babies so they can make more Mormons. Maybe it's like this big patriarchy thing. I'd believe it too. We can't do this. You're going to put that on the internet? Okay. Why can't you do that? You literally make millions of dollars exploiting your children. You can't do this?
You can hear like
how... Oh, kid's neck, bro! Jeez!
Since the moment was...
Kid's only like 5 months old, man. Kid's like... Jeez, did everybody else twitch when you saw that?
You're so sweet.
Why are you taking... Again, the fact that they say this was unplanned is so crazy because... First of all, they assume they can't get pregnant because she's breastfeeding. So why do you have all these pregnancy tests lying around, right? They were trying. They did this on purpose. This was to go viral. And mission f***ing accomplished. That's how you can tell they're lying. Because mission accomplished.
I'm currently sitting there trying to pee. I think I totally forgot the camera was still on.
Yeah.
Oh, did you totally forget? Mm-hmm. Because you guys are so chronically online and film everything. You forget the camera's on. I almost believe that.
I didn't know that you were recording even then.
We didn't watch this until like 2 months after this happened.
This is probably
2 months. What?
Like maybe our fourth time watching this video.
I don't even know what I'm doing at this point.
It's gonna be alright.
It's just getting darker.
It's gonna be okay.
I'm pregnant.
Hey, they keep going over and over and over again, man.
Oh my God.
You know why they're doing that? Because this video had to be a little bit over 8 minutes or whatever to monetize it. So they just kept repeating it. So again, mission accomplished. This was planned. And why is that a bad thing? Why do you lie about that? Why would you lie about something like that? You guys want multiple kids. It's because they needed this to be a different version of the other one, right? This is planned. They want to go viral because they want to use, hey, 5 months, and they've used this a million times on their channel. You know, finding out I'm pregnant, 5 months postpartum, blah, blah, blah. They've posted this multiple times with different titles. So, of course, this was planned, and this is fake, and it's, which in the turn means it's a f***ing lie.
Watching that video makes my chest tighten because I remember exactly how I felt in that moment and how nauseous I was and overwhelmed I was. Do you feel that way?
You've said this 4 times already in this video and I've fast-forwarded, so it's probably more like 6 times.
You know what it is? Sometimes.
Sometimes. I've really come to be really excited about this pregnancy. Yeah. I'm so excited for Griffin to have a sibling that's close in age with him. And I'm actually glad this happened to us. I really am.
Yeah, that's why.
I'm actually glad we planned this.
I always hate the word accident because it has a negative connotation. This pregnancy technically was an accident, I guess. Yeah.
Oh my god. Scabby. You know what? I hate using the word accident, but this kid's an accident. Scabby 2023.
Because we were not planning on having them so close together. It's just literally how our family was meant to grow. And yeah. It was how everything was meant to happen. And I know there's not more on our plate than we can handle. We have such...
You don't do anything. You don't have real jobs. You literally stay home and film your lives. So yes, this, and it's content. This is only good for you. This doesn't take away from anything. It doesn't take away from time. And they're trying to, you know what's so funny about family vloggers and people like this and influencers? Like, they try so hard to tell you they're just like normal people. When regular people watch this shit, do you not feel a little bit offended that you have to like go to work like a pleb, work your ass off, don't make a ton of money, a lot of you don't, you know, and work till the sun goes down, you have to put your kid in childcare. Do you not get a little bit offended when people like this try to say that they're normal when they're absolutely not? They have no problems. They don't have any issues, but they want to make it appear like they're just rego plebs and like the poors. Does that not piss anybody else off?
Great support system, and I think Griffin's gonna be a great big brother, yeah. Even though he doesn't even know what that is at all.
It's unexpected. It's more of a surprise when you really think about it. We have so many exciting videos to share with you guys and telling our family that we're pregnant. We've been a little overwhelmed with...
So now they're gonna film all that shit.
Starting our new podcast. It's been a lot, especially being parents. So if you guys haven't checked out our podcast, definitely give that a follow, but we have some really...
And what I just said before about them trying to be like normal people, even their podcast artwork is like, look how normal we are. We're just so tired. Chronically tired. Look at my pajamas and my house coat. We're just like normals, right? We're so normals. No, we're normals. Listen to us listen to us give you advice on life because we have never lived a normal life. Why would anybody ever take advice from people like this on a podcast? They have not lived a normal life. They don't even have, they've never had jobs. They don't do shit, man. Don't listen to people like, and the thing is that most influencers in the world who are big time influencers these days, none of them did normal shit. None of them have ever lived a normal life and give people advice. Ah! F these a-holes.
More videos coming your way soon.
I'm sure you, please support our child's college fund, children's now. Man, these people have more than enough money to send both, and they can have 400 other children, and you know they are going to, because the only content that's bringing people to the yard now is baby content, and that should speak volumes. Twat and Scabby, get wrecked. Dumbasses. Let's recap. Twat and Scabby. You know what? I hate when people say kids are accidents. Also, Twat and Scabby. This kid's an accident. Ding, ding, ding. Morons. Everybody take a deep breath. Breathe out the toxic bullshit. Idiots. Why do you people watch these people? I have lots of people in my comment section about Matt and Abby. Like, I love these guys. Why? Why do you love people like this? For what reason? I think it's because people don't actually see how the sausage is made. Some people don't even realize when you see a family vlogger do certain things that they had to set that camera up first on a tripod somewhere and it just looks normal. It's not normal. These people aren't normal. Stop idolizing assholes and stop naming your kids weird shit. Sorry, I will stand on that platform. I know it's not very popular to say that because whatever, but I don't care. Because like I said before, I say the thing you guys are thinking. You're welcome. And you're amazing, incredible, and damn valuable. Don't you forget it, and don't fly flare, considering most of their airplanes are grounded. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs. Those a-holes. I'll see you tomorrow.